Hello everyone, welcome to the Vegan's Guide to the Most Commonly Asked Questions. Me and a Patreon have been working side by side on this project and we decided to put this together so that vegans have a resource they can use, especially new vegans. You might not know what to say when people ask you these questions. So we're gonna bang through about 11 that we thought were the most significant and see if we can help you guys out with that. Why are you vegan? I'm vegan because if harming an innocent being isn't necessary for my survival or my health, I refuse to participate in it. We genetically modify, selectively breed, mutilate, enslave, torture, and kill around 60 billion land animals and 2.7 trillion marine animals every year for no other reason than they taste good. Where's the justification in this? Eating animals and their byproducts is also the most contributing factor to some of the leading diseases, including the world's number one killer, heart disease, of which a plant-based diet is the only diet known to reverse. If you care about humans, it contributes to ongoing issues such as world hunger, threatens our environment as the leading cause of Amazon deforestation, marine habitat destruction, greenhouse gases, species extinction, and a host of other destructive forces plaguing the earth and jeopardizing our entire existence. Exploiting animals for food, products, medical testing, or entertainment is cruel, unnecessary, unhealthy, unsustainable, and therefore immoral. Why am I vegan? The question is, why aren't you? But we're designed to eat meat. Does watching slaughterhouse footage make you get hungry? A carnivore would. Do we have long sharp claws, pointy teeth, and run after our prey, and pounce on them and eat them raw, flesh, bones, brains, and entrails? A carnivore does. If it's our design, then why can we only eat flesh when it's been butchered, sanitized, pre-packaged, cooked, seasoned, and served with plants? If we're designed to eat meat, why does it drastically increase our risk of heart disease, diabetes, and bowel cancer? Sounds like a pretty bad design to me. But our ancestors ate meat though. Ancestors ate meat for survival. Current humans don't. We have thousands of plant-based alternatives. Ancestors didn't. Ancestors scavenged for what they could find. They didn't purposefully breed billions of animals into existence for the sole purpose of killing them and eating them. Hashtag ancestors didn't have factory farms. A hunter-gatherer's life expectancy was on average around 21 to 37 years old. Our ancestors also saw women and other races as second class and held slaves for their own advancement. Our ancestors have also killed millions of people in wars because of discrimination and lust for power. Do you still think we should model our behavior from that of our ancestors? Where do you get your protein and iron from? Vegans on average have less nutrient deficiencies than non-vegans. Where does the animal you eat get the protein and iron from? All protein and nearly every other nutrient comes from plants to begin with. Why are you filtering your nutrients through an animal? When you eat meat, yeah, there are some nutrients, but what about the baggage that comes with it? Saturated fat, cholesterol, and carcinogenic animal protein? If we can avoid harming animals and ourselves by going straight to the plant-based source, why wouldn't we? But I believe in humane slaughter. As long as the animal has a good life before they get killed, it's okay, right? How do we kill an animal in a humane way that wants to live? Humane means to show compassion. Is murder compassionate? Just because someone had a good life, would that justify ending it? If your parents said to you, Billy,
yes, mommy and daddy,
you've had a great life so far. We've treated you really well. But now, we're gonna have to slaughter you. How would you feel? Betrayed?
What the f-
But what if I had my own backyard hens that were free to roam around my property and I used them for eggs? What if I wasn't abusing them? Are you already vegan except for those eggs? Because if you're still consuming animal flesh, stolen baby cow's milk, and exploiting animals in other areas of your life, then we can't really have the backyard egg discussion just yet. But if you are, were the hens rescued or did you buy them unethically? When you take a chicken's egg, it distresses the chicken and they feel like they have to lay another. Do you only ever eat your backyard eggs? What if you're at a restaurant and it was egg as an ingredient? The fact that you still view eggs as food wouldn't deter you from eating them in other areas of your life. Would you have these chickens if they didn't provide you with a product?
I love my chicken. Give me those eggs.
Beside the fact that there's the same amount of cholesterol in an egg as there is in a Big Mac, it's still an issue to view our animal brothers and sisters as a resource. That breeds an exploitation mentality, which will gradually snowball into the issues we have with animal agriculture today. Chickens' eggs are part of their menstrual cycle. Is something that comes out of a chicken's butt vagina food?
Yum.
But God put animals here for us to eat. Isn't it humans who are playing God? By breeding billions of animals into existence, genetically modifying them, confining them against their will, and forcing them into a gas chamber to kill them for food that will eventually kill us? If they were placed here for our use, why is the use of these beings causing so much destruction to ourselves and the earth? Is a slaughterhouse a place of God? If God put them here for us to eat, why do they value their lives? Value their families, avoid pain and suffering, are sentient and experience their own subjective reality? Why would a loving God do that? Sounds like the work of the devil. God could have just made food that doesn't feel pain. Oh, wait a second, he did. It's called plants.
Whoa!
But if the whole world went vegan overnight, We would have too many animals on Earth. Wouldn't they take over? Well, why have we got so many animals on Earth to start with? We breed billions into existence annually. It's absolutely impossible for the world to go vegan overnight. As veganism expands, demand for animal products will decrease. Therefore, there'll be a gradual decrease in animals being bred into existence. FYI, cows, chickens, and pigs will not take over the world and try to eat you. But animals eat other animals. Why shouldn't we? Lions eat their own children. Why shouldn't we? Lions sniff each other's butts. Why shouldn't we? Lions frolic naked in the safari with zero technology and freely mate with whatever female they desire to without consent. Why shouldn't we? This is an appeal to nature fallacy. Good and bad things happen in nature, so we can't use nature as a moral guideline. Animals are not moral agents, and they act out of survival. Humans have plant-based alternatives to choose from. Lions don't. Hashtag lions don't build factory farms. Most animals are herbivores. Why do we model our behavior from what a lion does? But plants, don't they have feelings too? You really think chopping up a carrot is the same as stabbing a puppy? Plants do not have a central nervous system or a brain, therefore they do not experience pain or subjective reality. Plants are alive, but they're not sentient. They also don't have a brain to process, anticipate fear or death. Plants have intelligence just like your iPhone does. They both react to stimuli in the environment. They don't respond consciously like an animal does. There's not a reputable scientist on Earth that believes plants are sentient. Hey Siri, do you feel pain?
That may be beyond my abilities at the moment.
But I love the taste of meat and dairy. Do you think deriving pleasure from something justifies an act of violence? The vegan market has expanded so much, we now have great tasting alternatives to meat and dairy. Nearly every fast food restaurant can be veganized. GQ's Superiority Burger was voted best burger of 2015, and it was vegan.
Juicy!
Vegan food is some of the tastiest on Earth. And even if meat, cheese, and eggs do taste good, the question you have to ask yourself is, are your taste buds more important than an animal's life? Alright guys, so that was the Vegan's Guide to Most Commonly Asked Questions. Leave some of your most commonly asked questions in the comments section and we can see if we can make another video to this. Let me know if you like this resource. We can continue this as a series if you'd like. Go vegan, stay vegan, and be a vegan activist if you're not one. And I hope this video helps you with your advocacy. Peace, justice, respect, vegan. We'll be right back.